In this lesson, we are going to look at if something is considered as matter or not matter. In order to be considered as matter, you must have two things, volume and mass. When you have volume, you take up space, and when you have mass, you contain a lot of matter. If we look at this object right here, we have a few examples of matter. The first one is the glacier right here. It takes up a lot of space, so therefore it has a lot of volume. So we can see that it has a lot of mass as well, okay? Or we look at the cloud up here. It takes up a lot of space, and it has a lot of mass, so therefore it's going to be considered as matter. Or the water in the ocean right here. It has a lot of volume, and it also has a lot of mass. When we look at something, there are three different views that we look at. First one is the macroscopic view. Second, we have the microscopic view, or the particulate view. And lastly, we have the symbolic view. At this view, we can see with our naked eyes easily. At the microscopic or the particulate view, we had to use models of molecules to look at substances. For instance, look at the glacier here. The glacier is basically water in solid form. So we have water molecules arranged in a solid form. Or we can look at the water. Here we have water in a liquid form. And lastly, the symbolic view is basically we use numbers and letters to represent a substance. For instance, water is H2O and it's a gas form. Or we have the glacier, which is water in a solid form right here. And lastly, we have the water in the liquid form. So again, there are three views, macroscopic, microscopic or particulate, and lastly, symbolic view. In chemistry, we are observing the macroscopic view, and we are going to use the symbolic view to explain how matter undergoes changes. Let's look at an example of something that is considered not matter. First of all, abstract feelings, such as love, they are not matter. So abstract, emotional feeling. Then we have the visible light or other form of radiation, they are not considered as matter. Then we have energy. Any form of energy are not considered as matter. So again, we are defining matter by two things. It has volume and it has mass.